So you have the proper support settings, but now that you've set everything up, how do you approach adding supports to your model? Automated and manual supports both have their own use cases, but these will often depend on the resin and the type of model that you're using. It's also important to know when and where manual supports might be necessary. The main focus of adding supports is to ensure that the model stays attached to the build plate during the printing process, while preventing any distortion within the model itself. In order to achieve this, all islands, overhangs, or areas which aren't attached to the build plate require a support structure. For larger prints, these will often need to be hollowed out to reduce waste. Many new slicers today use a highlighting system to help draw attention to these areas, which will require supportive material, but this doesn't always catch every instance. While slicing software has improved greatly in terms of generating automatic supports, there are certain limitations which are still true today. Large overhang areas tend to have supports in unoptimized areas and lack an additional support material for the support themselves. A main area of concern is the overhangs that cover large distances, since these are prone to warping, especially during the first couple of layers. Normally, even with automated supports, they do not include enough in certain regions, so these will need to be touched up prior to printing. In most cases, lining any hard edges and corners with additional supports should be a major focus, since any warping along those areas will be noticeable in the final print. Tall and narrow support material tends to be a common issue with automated supports, and these will need to be reinforced to prevent them from bending or falling entirely. Luckily, it's fairly easy to address this issue by using one of two methods. Either the support pillar diameter can be increased, or additional support can be added to the pillar itself to increase its rigidity. Placement of automated supports in relation to the model itself can be a tricky issue to address. For highly detailed models where supports need to overlap, there can be an issue with these being generated too closely to the model itself. When a model is hollowed out, something in the internal supports can prevent drainage holes from properly draining resin. In most cases, these will need to be moved out of the way. This becomes especially prevalent when a resin is more elastic and prone to bending. While manually adding supports allows for a greater amount of control over the end product, this can be a time-consuming endeavor. Very important to take into account is the fact that manual supports need to be double-checked for any missed regions, and therefore using a validator can aid in this process. For highly detailed projects, I do find that adding manual supports allows me better control over the final product, whereas for a more simple project, the automated supports tend to give me about 95% of the way done. So while automated supports isn't the perfect solution, it does provide a good starting point from which to work from. If you've been doing 3D printing for a while now, you'll probably want to check out my more advanced video, which goes over how to model custom supports within a 3D modeling software.